All right, y'all, so Jay ordered before me. I took his food that they brought out when he wasn't here, and I moved it over to another table so he don't know. And this food's taking a bit, bro.
Bro, we just ordered like 5 minutes ago, bro.
Yeah, but like,
we literally just ordered. Wait, where's my thingy?
What?
Oh, it's, wait, what number is it?
39?
Why would you do this to me? What do you mean, why would I? I wasn't here. I was in a woman's bathroom. Doing men things. I hope you know.
Man, it's 9:29 in the morning. I'm up, I'm out the house. I was heading to work. I look at my phone and I didn't realize I had a text from my boss before I even left telling me that basically like I didn't have to come until 12:30. So hey, W day, but at the same time, I'm like, dang, I'm already up and out the house. But low-key a blessing because I get my gas like I need. I got 15 miles in my car. My work's like 14 to 17 miles away, so I definitely need it. And on top of that, I do need to get my gas is what? Move. Gas is cheap. Hold up, young fella. We chilling. Either way, man. So, why is this window down? I mean, this. I hope I didn't put that down just now. I hope it wasn't down all night. It's been raining. Either way, though, for see, this is the problem. I be focused on everything at one time, bro. But yeah, so I have to go into work. Y'all know my back's been hurting. Y'all see, I have my heating pad ready and my pillow ready. You know what I'm saying? Have my back feeling good today. But what I really need to do is go to the doctor. And I'm supposed to be meeting up with Jay and his sister later to hang out or something. So I probably need her to get this out of the way. So I might as well head home, eat my breakfast. That junk was smelling good. And then, you know what I'm saying, go get my back checked, but also working with my boss wants me to work on. I got a lot to do, but we can get it done. You know what I'm saying? I'm a dog like that. You know what I'm saying? I gotta tell y'all, so if y'all been keeping up, y'all know what I'm saying, my back's been a little achy lately. So I ended up going to urgent care today to get checked out. They told me something about maybe like a strained nerve or something with a nerve. I don't remember. I gotta read my sheet. All I know is that they gave me some like a topical cream or ointment so I can put on my back. And it does help. Like, I felt it helping a little bit, like loosening up. And they say hopefully by the weekend, I got to apply like 4 times a day, but hopefully by like the weekend, by the end of the weekend, it should be done. I think it's kind of funny though, because like, dude, quite literally, I go back to school Monday, bro. I'm like, dang, I just want all this to be done. I just want to get going and be like, I don't want to like have to deal with all this stuff, but it's okay. Things happen sometimes, you feel what I'm saying? But you don't stress about it, you keep going. Like sometimes I just have to catch myself, you know what I'm saying, before I really like start to kind of get aggravated. Because sometimes like, you let little things get bigger than they are, you know? And a lot of it just comes from not taking a moment to breathe and think. You know, I wonder, like, with my videos, I wonder what makes one of my vlogs better than the other? You know what I'm saying? Because in my opinion, you know what I'm saying, I think every word is a good word. Not because it's my word, because I think I did a better job in any of these. More so, okay, there are some where I think I do better jobs, more so just because maybe I studied better than per se. But my thing is anything, just keep it inside, anything from the Lord, anything word oriented, anytime we're speaking about the word, they're all important and they all hold value because they're all supposed to grab something and somebody's supposed to teach a lesson to grow. You know what I'm saying? So I don't know if I can value the vlog by that. I think all of those and that in like all those points, like I watched Devotion with DeMarcus. Please watch his channel, it's amazing. And a lot of times his videos are almost the same thing over and over again. And that's not a bad thing, because what it is repetition. Of course, he always adds extra stuff. I mean, like, my point, he's always teaching, and he's repeating things so we actually learn. And so I go there not looking, you know what I'm saying? I'm not always going just to, like, look for a different sermon. I'm just looking to learn something, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, he repeats the same thing. I'm trying to learn something. But with my videos, you know what I'm saying, with my vlogs, you know what I'm saying? I go through my days. I kind of go through my days. Sometimes it really just be yapping in the car. That's mainly what this is. And I wonder, like, when I'm yapping, is it when I'm saying something important, when I'm just saying something silly? What I wonder what makes like these vlogs different from one another that really like sticks out. Cause that's why one thing I really want to figure out how to really improve upon these videos, you know? Cause I mean, after a while, I could do these videos for 5-6 years. You know what I'm saying? And it'd just be me sitting here doing this. If I have fun with it, no problem. You know what I'm saying? But of course, you know, you wanna grow the family. You know what I'm saying? So anything that can help with that. But at the end of the day, though, you know what I'm saying? If I just enjoy yapping, I'm gonna sit here and yap. Y'all know I'm a yapper. all of our gospel mission. Y'all know, I never knew that was a, that's funny. I always see a crowd of, this is where, the area I'm in right now, is where a lot of, like, homeless people will come in. I see them on these corners, and it's so sad. But I'm assuming right there's a church that helps with somebody who has, like, a kitchen in there. Yesterday, I actually visited one of those kitchens that a church, like, a church has open, and people come and get food there. You have to pay, of course. But, I mean, I was thinking about, like, what's the point of a church having a kitchen if they're only open on Sundays? And if you hear me, and you're and what I'm saying is, I'm not saying that why the churches are only open on Sundays, and then why is there a kitchen? I'm saying if they have a kitchen, the kitchen should not just be open on Sundays. I think that's a useful tool, bro. Like, we could feed people with that. You know what I'm saying? More than just putting, because again, homeless people don't have a home. They can't cook. You know what I'm saying? Like, let's open up the kitchen, open up the doors, and I'm saying have people come eat. Of course, the food costs money, so of course you need to have a way to do that. But I'm just saying, the kitchen, we can solely use the kitchens like cheap food as a way to give back. You know what I'm saying? A way to share. But you know what I'm saying? That's what I think about. You know what I'm saying? But hey, I don't know. All right, y'all. So Jay ordered before me, but he's in the bathroom right now. So I took his food that they brought out when he wasn't here, and I moved it over to another table so he don't know. So he won't know that it's here. So when he comes here, they're going to bring my food first, and he'll have no idea. He'll be like, why the heck do you get your food first? So it's a W idea, bro. Not a prank, but a prank all in the same time, bro. Oh, he's coming. James Berry of House Lame Butt. Berry. Of House Lame Butt.
James Berry of House Berry. First is my name, King of the Andals and the First Man. Protector of the realm and Lord of the Seven Kingdoms. Yeah,
what the hell's
watching, man?
What a nerd.
Anyways, I watch the exact same show and I don't act like that. Dude, this guy will call me and he'll be like, boy, who is your Lord? You know what I'm saying? Like, he's weird. Who does that job, bro? I would never do that.
Bro literally does this to me like every day, bro. Like,
cat, bro. Anyways, bro, how you liking the rain out here, man?
The rain? Oh, I haven't got to experience much of outside because obvious.
They don't know. I didn't tell them.
Well, basically, guys, you know, on Tuesday, bro, got into a crash. I wasn't in fault though, but my car is cooked, so I haven't had a car in like 2 days, which is usually fine, but you know, I want to make money, bro, and I can't make money.
Did I tell you they released the footage of your crash?
No, they didn't.
Yeah, I'm pro. If you go on the
did they actually?
On the NYPD thing.
Did
NYPD.
They actually?
Yes, dude. You can find it.
Seriously?
You can find it. No.
I'm about to say it, bro. I wanna see that shit, bro.
I can see Jay in the car. Jay was
that's crazy, bro. Hey, if y'all ever get in a car crash, bro, I would have wished on my worst enemy, bro. Because I could have been a lot more hurt, but I'm not hurt.
So they sent a notification to me and all my boys. I'm not even on Active 60 no more, but I still get notification. They were like, Jay stopped suddenly. And I'm like, what the world? He did? And so I was like, he's okay. I'm sorry. I'm like, I'm sure he didn't get in a crash. And then I see the boys texting the group chat. And they're like, I called Jay. He didn't pick up. I called Jay. He didn't answer. I said, oh, shoot.
Yeah, I saw the messages. I was like, bro, I said I didn't answer, but I was in a freaking crash.
Man, this food's taking a bit, bro.
Bro, we just ordered like 5 minutes ago, bro.
Yeah, but like, but
we literally just ordered. Wait, where's my thingy?
What?
Did you move my thingy?
No.
Oh, shoot. What number was it?
39?
What did you move? Oh, it's right here.
He found it.
Why would you do this to me?
What do you mean, why would I? How you gonna blame me? How do you know
because
it was me?
Because you moved it. You were the only one here. I was in a bathroom.
I wasn't here. I was in a woman's bathroom.
Doing men things.
I hope you don't get your food.
Wow.
Yep. I hope you don't get
my card declined. I had to put money in my account.
Yeah.
I'm like, I have money. I go look, I had $8 to my name and I needed 9. So I was like, oh shoot, let's go move it. It's been a long day. I paid $140 at this Hobby Lobby place earlier for work, so huh.
They gonna reimburse you?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and I still gotta go back tomorrow and get more, so.
Hey. How much you gonna spend tomorrow?
Probably like 27. That's it. Okay, not bad. I'm buying dude, these earrings are gigantic, dude.
What, the ones you got on?
Yeah, these are big earrings, dude. What the heck?
Not really.
They feel big. Like,
they do like medium size.
Yeah, I don't ever wear them that big. If you're here, I'm gonna assume you're walking down the path of righteousness. I'm gonna assume that you're searching for Jesus Christ, and if you're searching for him, that you know him. I'm hoping that you're somebody who's put your faith in Jesus Christ. And the reason I'm hoping is because this message is specifically for you.
And if you're not a believer yet, that's perfectly fine, because I promise this message relates to you just as well. Because one thing that I know is that before I met Jesus Christ, I was yet a sinner. Before I met Jesus Christ, I was lost in the world. And even after knowing him, there were times I forgot where he took me from. Sometimes I forget just who I used to be, just who I was, and just what I used to get into. I forget sometimes that I have desires, I have lusts, I have temptations, and I sometimes want to taste the appetite. I forget sometimes that the only reason I've been taken from where I was is because Jesus came in my life and changed me, and the Holy Spirit changed my appetite and my desires. But sometimes I forget just where he took me from. Sometimes I allow myself in the new situations I'm in to blind me just from where God brought me from. And many times I don't accredit the change in my life to the one that changed me. And so today I want to tell you, do not forget. Do not forget where God brought you from, because the moment you forget is the moment your relationship with God starts to change. It's the moment you start allowing your temptations, your tastes, your appetites to reappear, because you're forgetting, what brought me from where I was? Why am I not like that anymore? Why should I not be like that anymore? The moment you forget where you come from, you forget who brought you through and what he brought you through. And one thing I want to let you know is that we cannot forget, because the things we've been through were lessons for a reason. These were things we went through to teach us. Do not forget these lessons, because a lost lesson is lost knowledge, and knowledge is power. Because our knowledge keeps us in relationship with God. We were once blind to the truth of who he is. And now we see who he is because he's revealed it to us through his son, Jesus Christ, when he came on the earth. And the Holy Spirit that indwells in us now because we've been saved. Knowledge has been given to us. But we cannot forget, because if we forget this knowledge, we lose our power. And that power is found in God. And so therefore, if we start to lose that knowledge, our relationship with God starts to change. Because we allow ourselves to fall back. So we can't allow ourselves to fall back where we went. And the reason we can't fall back is when we hold on to that knowledge. And when we forget the goodness of God, we forget what he's doing in our lives, we forget where he took us from and who you and I used to be, we allow the old things to become new. And not in the way where old things become new and we change. I'm talking about you allow those old things to reappear. And you're supposed to be past your past. But a lot of us keep looking in that rearview mirror. It is time to stop forgetting where God found us and where he took us from. He changed a sinner into a righteous man. He changed a sinner into a righteous woman. He redeemed what looked to be unredeemable. He gave beauty to a person that seemed as if no matter how much makeup you threw up on them, how much jewelry you put upon their neck, there's nothing you could do to change the look of this creature. But God came in and said, they shall be beautiful because they are mine. And reading Ezekiel the 16th chapter, it is quite clear that God made beauty out of the beast. And I want you to understand, it is time to stop forgetting who changed us. It is time to stop falling back into sin and acting as if it's normal. Because one thing that Israel kept doing is God would take them from somewhere and they would get in a new situation. They'd have all these new things. They'd be blessed and God would bless them abundantly. And they'd forget who blessed them. See, they got lost in the blessing. They got lost in what they had. And many of us now as Christians, we get saved and we forget exactly where we came from instead of who we are. I mean, many of us are from some hard situations, families in terrible situations. And some of us are from the best in the world. But no matter where you're from, your soul at one point was in a position of lostness. And God came in and changed that. And I'm telling you, there is nothing like having your soul saved. There is nothing like having an eternal security in your spirit. And the moment we have that, there's a different feeling to life. And many of us can forget what gave us that feeling, what gave us that change. And so what we do is we start falling back and looking for those feelings in the world, not understanding that can only be pleased and felt in God. Many of us get these blessings and we start to flaunt them. We start to use these blessings for evil and sin, and we lose our way and fall back because we forget the one that changed us. Don't you dare forget God. Don't forget God. That is what I want to tell you today. Do not forget God. Do not forget. Because while I'm reading Ezekiel the 16th chapter, one thing that Israel just keeps forgetting, and the number one thing they forgot, is they forget where they began. And they forget where God took them from. Have you forgotten where God took you from? Don't you dare forget, because I promise you, that person is not too far away. Your past is your past, but I promise you, if you forget what brought you from where you were, there is a very large chance you may end up in the same exact situation. Reap what you sow. And so if you end up reaping the same wickedness that you were used to live in, there's a very large chance that you are going to be reaping a whole lot of that wickedness because of what you've sowed. But then there's this one thing that I love this about God, his mercy. And so while reading Ezekiel the 16th chapter, God goes on, it's about 63 verses, I believe, 63, 64 verses in Ezekiel the 16th chapter. And God is just going on about the sins of Israel. He's talking about them as his wife and about how God dressed them up. He took them from a place where they were thrown and cast away in the street, and he clothed them. They were yet naked, and God clothed them. He changed them. He built them up. He gave them all that they had, and yet they forgot where God brought them from. They forgot God himself, and they were pleasing themselves with the world. They were pleasing themselves with these sins, and they fell into these things, and they were as adulterers because they had a relationship with God, but they were prostituting themselves and whoring out in the streets with the world. And we ourselves as Christians can prostitute ourselves, whore ourselves out by giving ourselves to these things in the world. Because what we're doing is I hate saying it, we're cheating on God. Because what we're doing is that we're pleasuring ourselves with the things of the world when we're supposed to find pleasure in the things of God. And you're not alone. We all do it. I myself in my life can find many times where that. But the thing is, when we remember who God is, who he is, and what he has done in our lives, it gets very difficult to fall back into that old legs. I promise you, nobody wants to go back. Because once you go back, you remember just where you were. I was going to hell. I was condemned. But God came in and said, you are now saved because you are now mine. God said, you are mine. And so why do we forget? Many times we forget because we get too caught up in where we are now, forgetting the one who's been along with us in this journey from the beginning. He's the one who began the journey. How can we forget him? But even when we forget, the beautiful thing about God's mercy is that he doesn't. God always remembers. And so in the end of Ezekiel 16 chapter, after hearing all this stuff that God is going to do and his wrath is going to pour out on Israel because they forgot, God reminds them, though. He makes it clear that he hasn't forgot. He remembers. These are his people. And so even though they've done all this wickedness, even though they deserve all the condemnation, God's mercy is still there. He says he's going to make another covenant with them. God is going to save them and take them from where they were. And it's all because while we forgot our relationship with God, we forgot who he is, he never forgot who we were. And what he said to us in the beginning is that he said, you're mine. And so, yes, you may go around living your life as if you don't belong to nobody, living your life as if nobody's put a claim on your name, but God said, you're mine. And so even when you forget, God never does. So that mercy is laid out before all those who choose to come back in repentance and remember who God is. Because just because you forgot, I promise you, God can remind you if you just seek the one who remembers you. Because he said, you're mine. Don't you ever forget your God's. Don't you ever forget who he is and what he's done in your life. Because that change, that knowledge is your power. And it all begins with the knowledge of who God is. And he has revealed himself to you. Do not forget just what he has done for you and will do. He said, you're mine. Let us pray. Dear God, I say thank you today because you are our God. Thank you today for victory because we stand on the side of the one that never has taken a loss. Thank you today, Lord God, for your love because we stand with the one, Lord God, who gives unconditional love to those, Lord God, that don't deserve it. We say thank you because you care for those, Lord God, who live life as if we don't even know you. And so we say thank you, God, because you remember us even when we allow ourselves to act as if we've never known you. We say thank you, God, because you care for us, even in the midst of times where we act as if the world is just more meaningful than you. You always care for us. You always remember. And we say thank you. And when we don't remember, God, we ask that you remind us. When we fall short, we ask that you pick us up, Lord God, and set us back on the path of righteousness, Lord God, walking with you and towards you at all times, Lord God. We say thank you for your love. Thank you for your hand. Thank you for your banner, Lord God, that we can wear everywhere we go and say we are his. Remind us, Lord God, to never forget whose we are. It is in Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we all pray. Amen.
That's nice.
Well, y'all, join us with this vlog, man. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe. For your environment, hey, the limit. Young and winning, move straight out of state, ain't coming back. They call me Alex at the crib, but they be on the track. My homie Dorsey saying that it's me, but he the Mac. The shorty call me Chester, she a fly that I attract.